Good evening. Welcome to St. Joan of Arc. Our entrance song is number 553, Come, Now is the Time to Worship. We will sing the first part twice, the second part twice, and the first part one more time. Please stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you died for the sins of all. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, your praise arises from every nation. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, your mercy blots out every sin. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We pray. Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son.
Let us pray. O God, who have prepared for those who love you good things which no eye can see, fill our hearts, we pray, with the warmth of your love, so that loving you in all things and above all things, we may attain your promises, which surpass every human desire. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, observe what is right, do what is just, for my salvation is about to come, my justice about to be revealed. The foreigners who join themselves to the Lord, ministering to him, loving the name of the Lord, and becoming his servants, all who keep the Sabbath free from profanation and hold to my covenant, them I will bring to my holy mountain and make joyful in my house of prayer. Their burnt offerings and sacrifices will be acceptable on my altar, for my house shall be called a house of prayer for all peoples. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, I am speaking to you Gentiles. Inasmuch as I am the apostle to the Gentiles. I glory in my ministry in order to make my race jealous and thus save some of them. For if their rejection is the reconciliation of the world, what will their acceptance be but life from the dead? For the gifts and the call of God are irrevocable. Just as you once disobeyed God, but have now received mercy because of their disobedience. So they have now disobeyed in order that, by virtue of the mercy shown to you, they too may now receive mercy. For God delivered all to disobedience that he might have mercy upon all. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
Jesus proclaimed the gospel.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. At that time, Jesus withdrew to the region of Tyre and Sidon. And behold, a Canaanite woman of that district came and called out, "Have pity on me, Lord, Son of David. My daughter is tormented by a demon." But Jesus did not say a word to her. Jesus' disciples came and asked him, "Send her away, for she keeps calling out after us." He said in reply, "I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel." But the woman came and did Jesus homage, saying, "Lord, help me." He said in reply, "It is not right to take the food of the children and throw it to the dogs." She said, "Please, Lord, for even the dogs eat the scraps that fall from their master's table." Then Jesus said to her in reply, "O woman, great is your faith. Let it be done for you as you wish." And the woman's daughter was healed from that hour. The Gospel of the Lord. All are welcome. All are welcome is the theme of all three of our readings today. God's plan is for a universal church that includes everyone on earth. What is this universal church? Who's a part of this church? And how can we foster God's goal of a universal church on earth? Many years ago, I was attending the marriage of a good friend in his Episcopal parish. As the service progressed, I was surprised that most of it was very similar to our Roman Catholic Mass. I was surprised it was the same creed that we say, and that even included one holy Catholic church. And I was thinking, how nice of them to include us Catholics in their Episcopal prayers. But I really missed the point. Later, when I learned the meaning of the word Catholic, it all made much more sense. Catholic means universal, all-embracing.
St. Ignatius of Antioch, in the year 110, first used the term Catholic Church. He recognized that God's plan and Christ's mission was to have one universal church that includes everyone, every one of God's created children. In our first reading, Isaiah is beginning this process 5 centuries before Christ. He writes, "The foreigners who join themselves to the Lord, loving the name of the Lord and becoming his servants, them I will bring to my holy mountain." He's saying that God does not welcome only the people who are Jewish by birth or descent, but everyone who loves and worships him. All who love and worship and serve God are welcome. All are welcome. St. Paul was a devoted Jewish believer who saw and embraced a new pathway in Christ. He began his mission work teaching and preaching to Jewish communities all around Asia Minor. While there were some successes and some Jews became Christian, he faced a lot of rejection and severe persecution. Over time, his focus shifted mainly to bringing Gentiles, non-Jews, into the Christian faith. But he never stopped praying and hoping that his Jewish people would come to faith in Christ. "I glory in my ministry in order to make my race jealous and thus save some of them." St. Paul recognized the goal of a universal Christian church that could hold both Jew and Gentile. All are welcome. In our gospel today, Jesus doesn't seem to come across as very welcoming to this Canaanite woman. Remember that the Canaanites were the nomadic tribes that occupied the Promised Land before they were pushed out by the Israelites and then settled to the north, where their descendants live to this day. Their pagan gods and practices were very much against the beliefs and practices of the Jews, and they were not well liked. In our reading, Jesus is traveling in the north of Israel and encounters a persistent Canaanite woman who firmly believes that he has the power to cure her daughter. At first, he ignores her, but she persists. Next, he tells her that she's not part of his mission, but she persists. Then he insults her and calls her a dog. She accepts this insult and then tells Jesus in the same breath that she believes and trusts that the power and mercy of God should extend to all. "Please, Lord, for even the dogs eat the scraps that fall from the table of their masters." Jesus has made his point. This woman, who would be despised by a devout Jewish person, has profound faith and belief in the divinity of Jesus and the power of God. He praises her faith and heals her daughter. Jesus' church is a universal church. All are welcome. So God's goal, described by Isaiah and St. Paul and demonstrated by Jesus, is one universal Christian church for all. How are we doing? If God loves unity, man seems to love division. From the earliest days of the church, there has been division, and it hasn't stopped. At most recent count, there are 45,000 different Christian denominations and sects in the world. 45,000. Not quite the one holy Catholic church that we pray for. Do you think this is what God had in mind? Even today, our U.S. Roman Catholic Church is facing divisions. There are some who believe we should go back to our practices of 70 years ago. There are others who wish to proceed very rapidly forward with major changes to long-standing traditions and beliefs. But God does not want us to be divided. The church has always been diverse. All are welcome. So what do we do from here? In the past, our Roman Catholic Church has tried to enforce unity with wars and aggression, by fears and threats, and excluding others. It hasn't worked. What can we do? We can start to understand and accept the universal Christian Church. All who are baptized in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit are, according to our Roman Catholic teachings, a part of the universal Christian church. This represents 2.2 billion Christian people in the world. While we believe and know in our hearts that our Roman Catholic Church contains the fullness of belief and practice of our faith, we must accept that all baptized Christians are our brothers and sisters in Christ, in his one church, the holy, one holy universal church. All are welcome. Within our Roman Catholic Church, we must work to accept that there are differences of opinion. There have been and always will be. We need to avoid fostering and increasing division and instead try to understand each other and try to move the church forward on the path of unity that is God's desire. All are welcome. Beyond Christianity, we must remember that our Jewish and Muslim brethren worship the same God, the God of Abraham, who is our God. While not Christian in their belief, we all worship the same God. Jews, Muslims, and Christians make up nearly 55% of the people in the world and worship the same God. All are welcome. So what can we do as individual members of the Universal Christian Church to foster God's vision of one church for all his children? We must do what Jesus did. We must focus on love as the source of unity. In addressing the Universal Church, the Catechism of the Catholic Church states, above all, charity, love, binds everything together in perfect harmony. Within our own parish, we must foster love and understanding and work together to strengthen our church. As Roman Catholics, we must again focus on Jesus' teaching and path of love to reconcile divisions and move the church forward on God's path. We should be welcoming to those who have left the Roman Catholic Church. As members of the Universal Church of Baptized Christians, we should work together with our brothers and sisters of other denominations through charitable works and ecumenical exchanges to bring greater understanding and the love of Christ to each other. All are welcome. And to the wider non-Christian world, we must strive always to show the love of God and be the hands and face of Jesus to all. All are welcome. As Jesus showed us with the Canaanite woman, love is the way. All are welcome. Thanks be to God.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We bring our prayers to God, who extends mercy to all peoples and every race.
Let the faith and joy of believers attract unbelievers into God's loving arms. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That people of every race and culture seek to understand those who are different from themselves. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those on the verge of giving up find strength to persevere. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That every immigrant and alien be treated with dignity as a beloved child of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who form this community of faith root out prejudice and welcome every stranger. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the people of Maui, those who have died in the wildfires, and those who are suffering, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Please add your own intentions in silence. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We also pray for Kate Kapik and for the recently deceased Leonora Salmer. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we pray for the people of Ukraine. We pray for a quick end and peace to be established in their country, and that their country be returned to the state it was in before the Russian invasion. We pray to the Lord. God of Israel, in your mercy, you spared your people. Increase our faith in you and hear us in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated. The baskets are back. We'll be passing the baskets tonight. Just remember, those of you on the outside, pass it to the pew behind you. And they will be available in the narthex if you're not ready to make your offering now and are going to do it after Mass.
Our offertory song is number 618, I Have Loved You, number 618.
I have loved you with an everlasting love. I have called you, and you are mine. I have loved you with an everlasting love.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive our oblation, O Lord, by which is brought about a glorious exchange, that by offering what you have given, we may merit to receive your very self. Through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering canceled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life. And by ascending to you, our Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Peter, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Saint Joan of Arc, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
body of Christ.
Blessing of Christ.
The body of Christ.
Our communion song is number 534, the prayer of St. Francis, number 534. Thank you.
Let us pray. Made partakers of Christ through these sacraments, we humbly implore your mercy, Lord, that conformed to his image on earth, we may merit also to be his co-heirs in heaven, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Following all masses, the St. Joan of Arc Library will be open. A Catholic daughter will be available to answer questions. Registration for the 2023-24 Faith Formation classes will be held on Wednesday, August 30th from 6 to 9 p.m. and again on Saturday, September 2nd from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. Read this week's bulletin for more information or contact Tim Kelly or Ava Tabora. A class for Protecting God's Children in English will take place on Saturday, August 26th from 9 a.m. till noon. Peter Cruz will be facilitating this class. His phone number is in the bulletin insert. Our parish secretary, Carol Wald, will be out of the office Monday, August 22nd, and will return Tuesday, September 5th. The bookkeeper, Pam McRae, will be in the office on Monday, August 21st, and Monday, August 28th. Why do we tell you all this? Well, the reason that we have a secretary is so that I don't have to answer the phone. No, there's certainly more to it than that. Please be patient with us. If you call the office and leave a message, I will get to your messages as quickly as I can these 2 weeks as Carol takes her vacation, a well-deserved vacation, I would say. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ to love and serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Our recessional song is number 440, On Eagle's Wings. We will be singing verses 1 and 4.
You who dwell in the shelter of the Lord, who abide in his shadow,
make you to shine like the sun.